uniting our mission. Take one.
He adored Fordham Prep. He idolized it out of all proportion.
Make that, he romanticized it out of all proportion.
Better.
No matter what the sports season was, the Prep was always an institution that existed in black and white and pulsated to the great tunes of George Gershwin.
Make that Mr. Lagama and the Jazz Ensemble.
Okay, hang on, I don't love this. Let's start this over.
Igniting our mission. Take two. He was too passionate about the Prep and its mission.
As he was about everything else.
He thrived on the hustle bustle of the hallways and the nonstop action of the sports teams.
To him, the Prep meant passionate teachers, engaged parents, and, no, too corny for my taste.
And we're supposed to be getting them fired up for the auction. I mean, Bruce Beck is there.
Okay, let's try to make this a little more profound.
All right. Take three. He adored the Prep. To him, the school was a metaphor for how to educate young men in a world that seemed to hold no value in individual integrity.
To force its students to move beyond just taking the easy way out of everything. Nah, that's gonna be too preachy.
I mean, let's face it, we want to get some hot bids on these auction items here.
I mean, you can go to dinner on Arthur Ave with Dr. Petriello, for heaven's sake.
Alright, take four. He adored Fordham Prep. To him, igniting our mission was a prime example of the best of the Prep community coming together. In a world desensitized to the needs of the many, where so many other schools,
like Xavier,
just weren't living up to the Prep's standards, commitment to service, the arts, and learning.
It's too angry.
Okay, take five. He was ram tough and as ignited for the school's mission as he could be. And behind his enthusiasm for birding in Central Park with Doc Carney
was the enthusiasm of a true man of Fordham, who was hoping his parents would win the darn Turks and Caicos trip and take the two of us on vacation.
I love this.
The Prep was his school, and it always would be.